Hello friends, in this video we will understand how to write a C program to print the sizes of primitive data types. So the data types are int, float, char, double, void or bool. So we have to print the sizes of these primitive data type. So we want the output similar to this. That is, we should be told that what is the size of int, size of float and so on. So in my machine, size of int is 4, size of float is 4, size of char is 1 and so on. So in your machine, it can be different because the size of data type varies from machine to machine and compiler to compiler. So you have to check the what is the size of the data type in your machine. Now, how do we print these sizes? So in C, we have an operator called size of operator. What does this operator do? It tells me the size of the variable or the data type which I give it to as an argument. For example, we have declared a variable int a. Now, as you know, this a will take how much space? Now, int is 4 bytes, so a will take 4 bytes of memory space in my computer. Now, if I write printf percentile d size of a, that means it will tell me the size or the memory space that a has taken in the computer. So, a has taken how many bytes? Int, that is 4 bytes. So, size of a will tell me the 4, as 4 is integer. So I am printing the answer using the format specifier percentile d. So my output will be 4. Now, if I do not want to take any variable, I just want to print the size of a data type. So that's why I do not need to declare any variable. So for that purpose, you can directly write size of the name of the data type. So for example, I want to find the size of int. So I can write size of int. So it will again tell me that how much space a int data type occupies. So int take 4 bytes. So again, this will tell me 4. So my answer will be printed using percentile d. My output is 4. If I write size of double. Now, as you know, double is taking how much space? 8. So this data type size is 8. Now, this total is giving me 8 and 8 is again an integer value. So I am using percentile d to print the answer. Do not get confused that why we are using percentile d with double. So here the point to note is we are not printing any double variable or double value. We are printing the size of that double, and size of that double is an integer value. So I am using percentile d. Correct. Now let's see how this program works. So first we will include the header file, that is stdio.h, because we need the printf function so that we can print the sizes of various data types. So I will include stdio.h. After that, I will start the main function. As you know, return 0 is the last statement. So I will say return 0 inside the main function. Now this completes our skeleton code for a C program. Now I will print the sizes. So I will say printf size of int equal to percentile d. And I will not declare any variable. I will just write the size of int. So let's see, will this program work? So I got size of int equal to 4 as the output. So this program is working fine. Now accordingly, we can print the other sizes. So I will just copy and paste. So I have printed the sizes of int, float, char, double. And let's see, will this program work? So I'm getting size of int 4, size of float 4, char is 1 and size of double is 8. But the output is coming in just one line. So let's separate the lines. So I will use slash n. Let's run this again. And we are getting int is 4, float 4, char is 1, double is 8. So this is the correct output and all the answers are in the separate lines. Now let's print the size of void data type the same way. Now let's run this program again. So I'm getting the size of void as 1. Now let's print the size of bool data type. So I have written the size of bool. So let's run this program. Now here I am getting the error. So the point to note is this bool data type was introduced into the C99 version of the C language. Before that it was not present. To use this bool data type, we have to include a header file, that is stdbool.h. So let's first include that header file, hash include stdbool.h, and now let's run this program again. Now I'm getting the size of bool equal to 1. So if I put the slash in here, yeah, so size of bool is 1. And just for your understanding, I can also write as int a, and instead of this int I can write size of a. So again this program will work fine. Let's run this. Yeah, this program is working fine. So I hope you have understood the code and the solution. The link for this code is given in the description box. If you have any query suggestion, please put down into the comments. If you have liked the video, please subscribe the channel. See you in the next video. Bye bye.